looking pretty gross. But I wanted to try out some new stuff I've acquired over the, you know, the last however many weeks that I've acquired some stuff, and I figured we could try some stuff together and see if we like it. A lot of the stuff I literally have had for like weeks, but I felt like I didn't have enough stuff to like do like a full try-on video, so I just like didn't do it. And now I'm like, I don't know, I feel like I might have enough new stuff that I can try on, so I literally just like didn't use any of this for weeks because I wanted to be able to use it on camera when I used it for the first time. Can you tell that I was like swatching things? We'll get to that at the end. Oh no, I smudged it. It's fine. But I already put a primer on. I used the marshmallow primer from NYX, which is like my absolute favorite. And if you've watched any of my videos in the last like couple weeks, then you know that's like one of my favorites. But I'm going to try the new Morphe foundation today. I'm excited to try it. I've seen like a lot of people have liked this. So mine is called Light 2. I actually went one up from the lightest shade, so that's something. And when you got this foundation, they give you this like free foundation brush, which is super weird. And like, I don't know, I feel like I'm like painting it on my face. I don't know. We'll see how this works out. I feel kind of weird about it, honestly. But I'm just going to do what I always do, which is kind of just like squirt this foundation onto my face, and then we're going to do what we do. So let's start. Probably too much. I've never used this before, so I don't really like know how much I'm supposed to use. I actually never used any Morphe foundation before, like not that like fluidity stuff or any of the things. I know that one got like super panned, so I'm excited to try this though and see how this works out. So let's get to it. Okay, this brush is definitely not as like weird as I thought it was gonna be. I also feel like I definitely didn't put too much on. I feel like this is like kind of barely doing anything, but okay. All right, this is one coat. You can definitely still see some blemishes under it. It definitely evened my skin more. I think it's definitely like a light to medium coverage. I feel like I definitely need to like keep building. I think I'm probably gonna do another coat, but I do actually really like this brush, which I'm kind of surprised about because when I first saw it, I was like, this is dumb and I'm gonna hate this. But I don't hate it and it's not dumb. So I'm just gonna like build a little bit more foundation up on here and see how I can get it. So this is after I've built it up. I like the finish. It's definitely like earth shattering or world changing, but it's nice and I'm sure that I'll, you know, use it again. Do I think it's worth the like $20 price tag? I don't know about that. But I'm going to go ahead and throw on my concealer. I'm going to set my face and then I will be back to keep going. Okay, so my face is set and I'm back. I'm going to go in with this highlight. This is the Candy Floss highlight from ColourPop. I'm excited to use this one. It looks really pretty and everyone was like obsessed with it and it sold out super fast, so I'm excited to try it. It's like a very light pinky color, so I'm gonna go in with like a more tightly packed brush since this is a Super Shock formula and they're a little bit more creamy, so I feel like you need like a tighter packed brush. So I'm just gonna dip in here. Very lightly seeing something. Trying to peel the sticker off this mirror. Got it. Okay. That's a lot of glitter. Okay, that's like a glitter stripe on my face. I don't know if you guys can see that. All those little particles. This is like straight glitter. Ugh. I don't understand why this was selling out so fast. I'm gonna try to use my finger instead and see if maybe I can get a better look with that. Nope, still glitter. I feel like it definitely looks like maybe a little bit more metallic now, but it is still an awful lot of glitter. Okay. I don't care for this. When I look to the side here, can you see all, it looks shiny, but can you see all of the little particles of glitter? Yeah, I don't know that I'm gonna be using this very much. I am kind of upset that I even got this. It was like super huge and I thought it was gonna be really good, and like it definitely is metallic, but there's some serious glitter in here. If you like a glittery highlight, I'm sure this is for you. I'm not so sure this is for me though. So, moving on, let's move on to our eyes. Another thing that I got in the ColourPop thing that I got is this cream shadow in the shade Laurel. I got it because it looks a lot like the MAC Paint Pots, so I figured that I would try this as a primer. It looks like this, kind of looks like the Soft Ogre Paint Pot. So I'm going to use my finger and I'm going to take this and I'm just going to try to put this all over my eye. I was actually considering trying to use a brush too, just to see. I see some people use brushes with these sometimes, and I was just curious how well that works. So, well, that has stuff on it, so we're not gonna use that one. But maybe this like little end of this brush here, and let's see how this picks up. Looks like it's picking up quite nice, so. It's picking up really nice. I'm just gonna pack this all over my eye to cover up any veins and everything like that, and we'll get started. So I feel like that really did cover my lids. It really added like a nice bit of coverage on my lids. I like that a lot. I actually think I kind of like this more than the MAC Paint Pots. This was like a little bit softer and a little bit more like pliable and easy to put all over my lid, whereas I find that the MAC Paint Pots are actually quite stiff, and that I have a little bit of a hard time. Like, I feel like when I put the MAC Paint Pots on my lid, I usually use my finger because I feel like you don't get enough on a brush, and I feel like when I do it, it pills a little bit and it leaves almost like a streakier finish on my eyes, where I feel like this went on quite smooth. I think maybe because this is supposed to be a shadow. I don't know if the paint pots are supposed to be shadows or if they're supposed to be primers. Don't quote me on any of this. I'm not sure. All I know is that I do like the way that this goes on better than I like the way that my MAC Paint Pot had gone on. And I'm actually probably gonna get rid of my paint pot because I've had it for probably longer than you're supposed to have it. But anyway, I'm going to get into our next product. And our next product is the e.l.f. Mini Melt Palette. So this was like, I want to say like, was it like $4? Maybe a little bit cheaper, I don't even remember. But I liked this one so much from the mint collection. This is the chocolate mint. I liked the regular mint too, but I liked that this had some browns in it. I felt like it was more wearable than just the mint palette. I also do have the ColourPop Mint to Be palette, which is all mints, so I thought that this was kind of a change from that, whereas if I got just the matte or just the mint palette, it would kind of just be like the same principle as that. So I wanted to do this one. I just think that this brown color like right here is really pretty, and this is like a really good one to build up your crease. You know, I like a good dark crease, so I thought this would be really pretty. So I think I'm gonna do like kind of a brown neutral look, and then I might do like some of this mint in my inner corner, just like a little pop. So I want to try these. I've actually never tried any of the like mini e.l.f. shadows. I know people absolutely love these. I just have never actually tried any of them. So I'm gonna go in with this brush. I don't even know where this is from. It says Cleof, C-L-E-O-F. I don't know what brand that is. My aunt actually sent me a package after I had my surgery, and she sent me like all these different like cool little makeup things from Amazon, and there was this like big pack of brushes, and this is one of the ones in there, and I actually really, really like them. I think they're really nice, especially this little blending brush is really cute. So just gonna dip in with that. Not much kickback, which is nice, but it is picking up a lot of color on the brush, so that's a good sign. I think I'm gonna use this super glittery candy floss mirror here and just kind of pack. It is pigmented, that's nice. So I'm definitely seeing pigment right away. You can see that it's building already. That is nice. So I'm just gonna keep dipping down here and just build some of this brown in here. I'm just gonna build this up nice. I might even put it all over my lid just to kind of set the cream shadow that I used. Maybe I won't, because then I feel like maybe the shimmer will sit really nicely if I don't set it. I don't know. The struggle, you know? It's real. But I'm just gonna build this up for you. So apparently I forgot to start filming, so that's on me. That's my bad. But I started packing this brown into the crease. I haven't blended it yet, obviously, or else this would be a really shitty job. But so I'm gonna start blending with this same brush here. I used the same brush like this one that I used for my primer to pack it in. So I'm actually gonna take a little bit on my blendy brush, and I'm just gonna blend it. Blend like we've never blended. before. All right, so we have blended that brown out. Now I'm going to take this shimmer shade. I'm gonna take it right on my finger and I'm gonna pop it on my lid and we're gonna see how it holds. I'm excited to put it right on the cream shadow since it's still tacky because I feel like it's gonna like really grab it, hold on to it. It feels really creamy already. I've never used the shimmers in these. It feels really good, so I'm excited. Oh my God. That's ridiculous. I don't understand how they made this so good for $4. These shimmers are better than some high-end shimmers that I've tried. This is ridiculous. And these shadows are super, super pigmented. These are really, really good. If you have seen these e.l.f. things and you've thought about getting them and you haven't, like I did until I finally got this one, you need to get them because it's good. The hype is there for a reason. So I'm going to take this little brush here and we're gonna dip into this little minty shade here and go in on my, what's my crease, my inner corner. I think that's what I'm trying to say. It's a really pretty color because it's like a nice subtle green, you know, it's not like aggressive. You just kind of like see the green when you turn a little bit. It's like a nice soft green. Well, I feel cute. I like this. I'm actually gonna take some of the green here and just kind of like do a little brow highlight here. So I'm gonna take some eyeliner and I'm going to finish doing my eyes. Well, I'm just gonna finish my liner because I do have a mascara that I want to try, so I'm going to do that, but I'm gonna go ahead and do that and I'll be right back. All right, we lined, so that's good. Now I'm gonna go ahead in with a mascara that I'm kind of nervous about because some people seem to like it and some people seem to say that it's like the flakiest shit that has ever existed. So a little bit nervous about it because I'm kind of nervous that it's gonna like ruin my look that I've got going on right now because I'm kind of digging this eye look and I don't really want it to ruin it, but I'm gonna do it for you. That is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Mascara. My mom actually got this as an add-on with her Ipsy bag and she gave it to me, so I'm excited to try it. First thing I notice is that this mascara is like heavy. Like I feel like you could just like, you could probably hit someone with it. Oh yeah. But yeah, I'm excited. Also like all the weight is in the handle. It's like aggressively heavy for a handle. But we're gonna give this a shot. I'm kind of nervous it's gonna like flake off everywhere or it's gonna get gross or it's gonna like bleed down my eyes, but we're gonna see. To start, I like the brush, you know, I like the bristles. It's kind of got the look of like the Better Than Sex mascara from Too Faced. The handle is like really weirdly aggressively heavy, but that's okay. So let's just do this. Eyeliner on, so it's hard to tell, but I feel like this didn't do anything. I'm gonna finish my other eye and we're gonna try to see if I can make this look like something. After further examination and many coats, I've decided that this is mediocre. I did a lot of coats, like a lot. And I know that I have like eyeliner on, so it's kind of hard to tell, but usually I have very long eyelashes when I put mascara on. Like, I mean, obviously I always have them, but like, I mean, you can really, really see it when I put mascara on. And I feel like this really just doesn't show my eyelashes at all. I have many that I would prefer. Like, I use this one. This is the Voluminous Carbon Black from L'Oreal. This is way better than this, and the price point is quite different. So if you're gonna get a mascara, I would get a drugstore mascara before I would get this. I haven't even like tested it throughout the day, so I don't know if it's gonna be like, you know, I don't know if it's gonna be like crappy or if it's gonna flake off. I can just tell you my immediate reaction, which is that this doesn't seem worth it. Kind of just doesn't really do anything. Like, it's fine, it gave me lashes, but at what cost? No, I just it didn't do much. So I'm going to do my eyebrows because I just realized that I didn't, and then I will be back and we're gonna do the lips, which is weird because I feel like we like never do my lips, but we're gonna do my lips. And then I have a setting spray that I would like to try, and of course Kathleen Light said it, so we had to have it. Look at that, I have eyebrows. So I used the Faux Brow from XX Revolution. I'm actually out of my e.l.f. brow pencil right now that I like always use, so I'm gonna have to get more of that because that one's my favorite. So today for lips, I'm actually going to be using a sugar pill product. It is the Lip Shade Trinket, which I've been obsessed with for like years. I wanted to try this shade for a very long time, but I just never did because it was always kind of pricey. So I went into Ulta a few days ago and turns out they are discontinuing like the products that they're selling in store for sugar pill, I guess. I'm assuming they're still gonna sell them online because they're not on sale online, but they were on sale in store. So this was 75% off. So it's $18 and I saved $13.50 on it. So I got this for only a few bucks and I'm very excited to try it. I'm gonna start by lining my lips. So I'm gonna line my lips and come back. My lip liner is just this thing. It's called Stereoscopic. The lip liner from Poudier. I don't even know how to say this. I just bought a big pack of lip liners from Amazon for like $6 and it had like a million colors because I'm always trying to find lip liners for the colors. So this came with a bunch of colors and it's actually really nice. I'm not gonna lie, it's a little bit harder to work with than regular ones. It's like a little bit drier, but it does still work very well. So I like them. I'm gonna go ahead and line my lips and I will be back. I always feel ridiculous after I line my lips and I haven't done anything else yet. I feel like I look so stupid. But anyway, I've also started kind of overlining where I like connect my Cupid's bow here. And I don't know, I kind of like it. I think it looks kind of cute. So I'm gonna go ahead and try this. You don't need to hear any more about my Cupid's bow and my whole life story, you know? But here we go. So this is what the applicator looks like. I kind of like that it's got like that little tilt to it. I think it's nice. So this is like a mauve-y color and it does have like little kind of like gold sparkle flecks in it. So I'm just going to, also it smells, okay. Has anyone ever had those chocolate oranges at Christmas time? The ones that you like crack and like all the pieces come out? It smells exactly like that. Like exactly. Weird. I'm a hot mess when I put this on. I'm gonna have to leave. All right, so that's the finished lip. I actually really like it. It's kind of a dry formula. Not that it like dries your lips out, but like the actual formula itself is very dry. Like it doesn't feel wet when you're putting on your lips. I kind of was like looking in here and I was like, is it gone? Am I like putting on an old lip product? It's weird, but it is like, it already feels like it's dried down and it's not in any way like drying on my lips. Like my lips don't feel any drier. They just don't feel like they're gonna smudge, you know? But, not like crusty or gross at all. I mean, I know it's only the first few minutes, so we'll have to see. But for now, it seems like it's going pretty nice. So the setting spray I have is actually from 43 Beauty and it is the Glisten Up Illuminating Mist, which is also citrusy. I got a lot of citrus stuff going on today. But Kathleen Lights has talked about this before and she really liked it and I've always wanted to try it and they're always sold out of it. So they were having a big sale and this was available. So I decided to try it. Let's see what the mist is like. I don't know if you could see that. I can't tell if it's picking up on camera, but it's a pretty fine mist, so I hope it's not like too aggressive like that time that I thought the mist was gonna be fine and then I like sprayed myself right in the eyes. I don't know if anyone watching this has seen that, but it was aggressive. So I'm gonna go ahead and give this a shot. Oh God, okay, if it gets in your eyes, it burns a little bit. Just don't let that happen. I do like it though. It's giving me like a very dewy face. I like it and I like the way it smells. You do need to make sure that you shake it very nicely beforehand because all of the shimmer or like any kind of like illuminating factor that it has sinks to the bottom and it will separate. So you need to like really get in there and shake it good before you spray it. But all in all, I think it turned out really nice. I'll even, you know, take my bangs out so we can see how it looks all together. I am really happy with the look. I think it turned out really nice. And I would say most of the products turned out very nicely. Only a couple like disappointing things. So that's a pretty good day as far as I'm concerned. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope that, you know, you subscribe so you can see every time I upload something new to my channel. Thank you.